Hello, Phil here from Wings of Pegasus, and welcome to another analysis video. If you enjoy this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. On the agenda tonight, we're going back to 1991. We're going to be taking a look at Dan Fogelberg, and he's going to be playing through Leader of the Band. Let's get Dan up on screen and see how he gets on.
Child alone and wild, a cabinet maker's son. His hands were meant for different work, and his heart was known to none. He left his home and went his lone in solitary way, and he gave to me a gift I know I never gave. Quiet man of music, denied to simplify. He tried to be a soldier once, but his music couldn't wait. He yearned his love through discipline, a thundering velvet hand. His gentle means of sculpting souls took me years to understand. Leader of the band is tired, and his eyes are growing old. But his blood runs through my instrument, and his song is in my soul. My life has been a poor attempt to imitate the man. Oh, I'm just a living legacy to the leader. Brothers' lives were different, for they heard another call. One went to Chicago, and the other to St. Paul. And I'm in Colorado, when I'm not in some hotel, living out this life I've chose, and come to know so well.
I'm just going to jump in here. As always, the link's going to be in the description below so you guys can watch this video the whole way through without me interrupting it. There is so much going on here. And by the way, at the beginning of this video, Dan does a little intro to it explaining about the song and the fact that it was written about his dad. And fortunately, his dad got to hear it before he passed away. And it's really cool to watch the video the whole way through. And at the end, we also get Dan's voiceover right at the end of the performance. So that will be the voice that you can hear coming in. But in terms of what's going on here, Dan is playing the guitar totally faultlessly throughout this whole performance. And it is so well played, you don't even notice it. And this is the thing about the top singer-songwriters. When they are playing guitar, it doesn't really matter what the instrument is, but the guitarists who accompany themselves and sing, they always have such ability on the guitar that whenever there's a close-up of their face, you're not even taking in that they're playing the guitar at the same time, because it is almost like somebody else is playing it in the background, because it is so consistent, especially when playing on acoustic guitar. You've got to think about getting clean chords, not leaning on strings, the right hand going through the sequences. Here, we've got the thumb playing that running bass line the whole time, skipping over the A string. So from the E string to the D string, all of these technical elements that are put into this performance that are seamlessly played by Dan. He's so natural with the guitar and with his vocal delivery, and it's not as if he's playing really basic chord shapes and they're really easy to get clear. He's going into a bar chord, full bar chord shape, where it is so easy to get a buzz if you're not concentrating. We've also got an ascending run in there, which means that Dan's going to be picking two strings simultaneously in order to get those really clean. Again, whenever you're playing any kind of fill or run on the acoustic guitar and just just singing at the same time, it's going to be so important to keep it clean. There's no fret buzz or anything going on here. You can sit down, you can learn this song, you can play it fingerstyle, and when you start to apply the vocal over the top, obviously it now gets into a different league of mastery in order to be able to think about your singing at the same time as letting that right hand and left hand do all of those things that you've rehearsed. It's another stage to then inject dynamics into the playing. And this is something that Dan does seamlessly throughout this performance, to the point where there will be parts where you can't really hear the guitar because it's so low dynamically, but it's all intentional. The ebb and the flow of the performance is something that I mention about top artists. They have that dynamic range on their instrument as well as with their voice. So it means that if they want you to listen a little bit more closely to what's going on with that instrument, they'll just take that dynamic down and it will set a totally different mood. You'll also hear the same thing with Dan's voice, the way that he takes it down really low in terms of volume, and then he'll lean into chest voice a little bit more. And he's got this smoky quality to his vocal where it's not an out-and-out rasp, it's not real vocal distortion, but there's just a hint of that smoky tone that he's got going on, which makes it so easy to listen to because of the control he's got with it as well. I always mention about the top singer-songwriters being able to connect on such a deep level with an audience vocally, also with their instrument and with a song. And Dan ticks all of those boxes because with this particular composition, I like to watch top singer-songwriters with the lyrics on screen so that I can read along. Sometimes you might get a bad mix on a particular night of a particular performance and you can miss a word or two, whereas having the lyrics of the song there really mean you get the message of the song really clearly as it was intended. Another thing about Dan is that when he was releasing his albums in the 70s and especially the early 80s, when he was really at his peak, MTV was taking off and every band was making a video for their songs, but Dan wasn't part of that movement, or at least he opted out of making videos for his songs because he was of the belief that when you write a song and somebody hears it and they hear the message of that song, they're using their own imagination. And for Dan, that was a huge part of making music, was to give somebody a story, but then they interpret that story exactly how they want to. It's an individual story that they can imagine, and their imagination will come up with a different set of images to somebody else. So he was of that belief, and as a singer-songwriter, as an artist, that is what music is about and all art is about. It's subjective and giving the ability to other people to digest the music and interpret the message however they want and paint their own picture was something that Dan Fogelberg really wanted to do and not force an image on his audience. You know you're watching a top singer, songwriter, and all-round artist when you're never questioning any part of the performance. For example, thinking that there's not a full band here and you'd prefer to maybe hear a drum kit, some bass, some keys. It's just Dan, his voice, and a guitar. And that's all he needs to keep your attention for the whole performance. And we are going to have a little bit of keys that comes in for a solo of sorts throughout this performance. But up until this point, you're not questioning anything. But let's watch the rest of the performance.
Thank you for the music and your stories of the road. Thank you for the freedom when it came my time to go. I thank you for your kindness and the times when you got tough. And Papa, I don't think I said I love you near enough. is a growing old, but his blood runs through my instrument, and the song is in my soul. My life has been a poor attempt to imitate the man. Oh, I'm just a living legacy to the leader of the band. I am a living legacy to the leader of the band.
The song Leader of the Band cemented our relationship. There was nothing left unsaid when he passed away.
And there we have it. That whole performance, dare I say, with the keys that come in, the sound obviously is in there to keep the interest, but I think that acoustic performance didn't need anything else to come in at any point because of Dan's ability on the acoustic guitar. You would quite happily, or at least I would, listen to that fingerstyle playing, and the expression that's in there could definitely keep the interest. It's a shame that after watching this whole performance, connecting with the message of the song, that Lawrence Peter Fogelberg's name is obliterated by a playlist of hot new pop music videos 2019. This channel is the Dan Fogelberg Vivo channel. It's going to be controlled by Epic Records, a division of Sony Music Entertainment. And for me, this is a classic case of the music industry nowadays. Forget about the message of the song. Forget about who it was written for. We want to show you these new pop videos from 2019. It is disgraceful. Also, this, I know, running a YouTube channel, this playlist that they've got, you can drag it out the way. You don't have to put it in the way of Lawrence's name. Just talking about Dan's father, he was a band leader, hence the name of this particular song. He was a high school band leader, so he educated many generations about music. But also, his mum was a classically trained pianist. In terms of Dan's mum, Dan did play piano as well. He was a multi-instrumentalist. He also first started learning Hawaiian slide guitar. And if you do look at the credits on some of his albums, the amount of instruments he played on his own albums were just crazy. He'd pick up pretty much anything and get it down in the studio. While he was at school, he'd play in cover bands, and he then went to university and studied theatre and painting and all of those artistic things that a lot of singer-songwriters have an affinity for. He then played in venues around this time as well, cafes, and that's the time that Irving Azoff found him, discovered him, and sent him to Nashville in order to hone his craft. And it was when he was in Nashville that he became a session player and released his first album, Home Free, in 1972. And that didn't do amazingly well when it was released, but since then it has gone platinum. So the next album release that he had was in 1974, and that was Souvenirs, which was produced by Joe Walsh, and that fared a lot better because it gave Dan his first hit, and that was part of the plan, which got to number 31 in the charts. Throughout the 70s, he released 5 albums, and they either went gold or platinum. Since then, every one of those albums has gone at least platinum. I think 3 out of the 5 have gone multi-platinum. So has certainly sold well since the release back in the 70s. 1979 was when he released Phoenix, and that got to number 3 in the album charts. So that was a massive hit and an upturn in his success and popularity now entering into the 1980s. From a UK perspective, Dan didn't chart here with any singer-songwriter albums, but he did chart with the collaboration album he did with Tim Weisberg, the flautist, or flutist if you're in America. The track was called The Power of Gold, and that got to number 59 in the charts, and the album Twin Sons of Different Mothers got to number 42 here in the album charts. After the success of Phoenix in 1979, he then released The Innocent Age in 1981, and that was the peak of his critical and commercial success. 3 out of the 4 singles released from that album got into the top 10 in the singles chart. This song, Leader of the Band, came from that album, and it got to number 1 in the adult contemporary charts. He also got to number 1 with Longer in the same charts the year before in 1980. So he was on a roll in the early 80s. In 1984 is when he released Windows and Walls. In 1985, he released his album High Country Snows, and he had some top-tier bluegrass talent on that album. Ricky Skaggs, Vince Gill, Doc Watson, Jerry Douglas, amongst others. In 1987 is when he released The Exiles, and in 1990 was The Wild Places. In 1993, he released River of Souls. In 1999, he made a Christmas album, and 2003 was his last release, and that was called Full Circle. Unfortunately, in 2004, Dan was diagnosed with prostate cancer, and in 2005, he was told that it had gone into remission, and he announced the fact that he was getting over cancer, but unfortunately, by 2007, it had returned, and in December of 2007 is when Dan passed away at age 56. But again, fortunately, we've got Dan's performances and his songs that are going to live on forever. And it's great to have a stripped back performance like this, totally live, so that you can see the guy in full flow. And such a great message in this song. And one of those singer-songwriters that would write about such personal topics, you know that this is his life and this is his relationship with his dad, and it's also great that Lawrence could hear this song. So definitely click on the link in the description below to go to this original video, because then you'll get the benefit of hearing Dan's introduction to the song and the story behind it. But thank you guys so much for suggesting this video for me to take a look at, and keep those suggestions coming in the comments below. Let me know what you guys think, and if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe, and I'll see you guys at the next one. Rock!